In a recent video, you saw me build a backpack hanger for my new photo bag. This was a one-off proof of concept, something to test out. It turned out to be very functional. I built one for the shop and it's incredibly handy. So this video is going to start off a little series where we're going to try to take that idea and turn it into a real product. We're going to focus on the process of folded sheet metal, and in this case, folded aluminum to make this backpack hanger. This video is sponsored by Crescent Cardboard. Crescent, manufacturing materials for creatives for 5 generations in the Chicagoland area since 1902. My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up, and then you hit the bell. Hit the bell again so you get the little parentheses around it. That way you'll be notified every time I have a new video. Don't forget to check out the design and making merch just below the video on the shelf. T-shirts, hoodies, stickers, leggings, and phone cases. I'm going to lay down my visualization sketch here. I start off with a very light blue marker. I'm not using any pencil or anything. Just putting everything in with markers, blocking in all the values, roughing in all the shading and everything. I'm going to do an expanded video on this for the next video. But for right now, this is our sketch that we're going to build. And first thing I do is do like a base layout of what we're going to cut out. And we're going to use some Crescent mat board for that. And it's very useful for prototyping and mocking up sheet metal, as you can see here in some of these other mockups that I've made, in this case for a client for a toilet paper project. It's going to be coming out on Kickstarter soon, and I'll let you know when that product is available so you can check that out. We're going to make this mock-up in a series of layers, and we're going to build up the mat board in those layers to get the desired thickness of what our production part would be. We're going to make it in 3 layers. The first layer is going to be this marker board. It's a little bit thinner. I think it's 1.3 millimeters, something like that. The inner core is going to be the thickest, and then we'll wrap it again with some more marker board on the end. So first we're going to lay out the basic template of this thing, and here I'm just using a punch to do the center corner folded parts just like you would in a sheet metal part. Now I'm mocking this thing up not exactly the way it would go to production. I'm mocking it up in a way that I can bend up the cardboard in a reasonable manner without too much difficulty. I know many of you are asking, why build mock-up at all? What the hell? Why? Just build in CAD. And we will. Don't worry. You cannot underestimate the value and the importance of a mock-up like this. To hold something, touch it, feel it in your hands, try it, see how it works. Can you fit your fingers in there? How much does it weigh? How big is it? Those things cannot be gained from the computer. Only from a mock-up or some sort of a prototype is going to get you that. All right, I'm getting off the soapbox now. I realize that I actually have one of these hole punch things, so I don't need to use a hammer. And I finish out all the corners, corner fillets with that hand tool. Similar to way, in some ways, to leatherworking sheet metal is. I'm cutting out all the pieces on this thinner outside shell piece with a ruler, laying everything out with a pencil, and then just coming in with an X-acto and cutting everything out. So it's very much the way the part would actually be folded in sheet metal, not exactly the way it's gonna be for production, or at least the way I think at this point. I will draw in some of those other lines later where the part actually gets folded if it's not folded that way right now. Now I'm doing something here that your grandmother probably told you to not do, and that's take water and put it onto a paper product. In this case, I want to get a relatively clean bend in my mat board at this point, so I wet the fibers on the back, and that allows them to stretch and break, and I get a really nice clean break with my mat board here. I use a little straight edge to make sure I get that. So very much in the same way you would fold a piece of sheet metal, if you've ever done that before, I'm doing the same thing, and I'm basically use the water to make sure I get the break exactly where I want on my cardboard, and boom, we're going to break it and fold it here, and you can sort of see the basic shape that we're getting here right out of the gate. So I'm going to be building from the inside out. So I have adjusted this piece size-wise to be the inside diameter of what the part is going to be, because all the other pieces are going to get added on the outside. Trimming away a little bit on the inside here so I can get a good nice fit. And then we're going to glue that together. Here's a quick test with foam. There's none for the vertical position, but that may be included in the future. We'll put in a little glue here with the lure lock bottles that I have. Link below for those on eBay. We'll put a little weight on that and we'll let that glue up. Here's a little close up so you can see what those breaks are like on the mat board. You get a nice clean break. Now we're going to go to the next layer with that middle thickness here. You can see in the upper right, I show that. And this is a thicker material. We're just gluing these pieces on. We're not going to fold them out like we did on the first piece. Just glue that stuff on with some Elmer's glue. Get that good. And we're building up the thickness basically. This inner core here is about 2.5 millimeters thick, something like that. Also Crescent mat board material. And we're just going to put that on all the surfaces to build up that thickness. Now the last one here being the bottom, just using that white PVA Elmer's glue to glue everything together. Works fantastic for this. Some weights to keep everything nice and flat, square, and straight. So let's head over to the belt sander, and here we're going to radius all these edges to make it a little bit more like a sheet metal folded part, like an actual bend that you would get if you put this in a brake press, and the way it would be a little bit more for production. We got one more layer to add to the outside of this mock-up, and that's going to help that last layer bend correctly and fold like a sheet metal part actually would. And it's a little close up so you can see what that looks like. Sand out any remaining little rough edges, particularly in the corners. Get them nice and ready for the final cover of mat board. Here I've laid out the last one. This one I am going to lay out like I did the very first one. And you see me tipping over the mock-up to make sure everything fits. You have to guess at the radiuses of the corners. I think probably about 4 millimeters is what I guessed here on these pieces. Come in, punch out my part. And again, just glue the layers on top of each other. This one is probably the trickiest. You need to make sure that you get your layout correct here to lay everything up. But if you guessed right, and I actually left a little bit of extra material just to make sure so I wouldn't have any issues. Let that dry. We'll put a little weight on it, and we'll come back and we'll fold the next edges there. You saw me clean up at the bottom there at the very end of that last clip, and that was to clean out any glue that was in that radiused area there. I don't want to have extra material when I do the fold. And I use these binder clips to hold the mat board together. It works really well. So let's fold up the rest of this shape. I'm really looking for some feedback from the community here. I would love to kickstart this, maybe make 100 units, something like that. And I'm also looking for maybe additional features that you'd like to see in a backpack holder like this. So basically right now it holds a backpack and you can put a cell phone in it or a tablet in it to charge or to watch something. But if you have any other ideas for additional functionality, there are also some fingers in the front to maybe hang some keys. But if you have some other things that you think a utilitarian product like this could do, please leave that in the comments below. Would love to hear your ideas about that and possibly incorporate them into the final product. Let me know if you're interested in buying one of these for your home and use in the future. Because like I said, I'd like to do a run of 100 and do a Kickstarter campaign for that, and would love to get everybody's feedback. So now I'm just going back here and trimming out the other two layers of the mat board that we put on. I used that punch to do all the inner radiuses of the little fillets. The one thing about the punch is that it's tapered pretty heavily, so you have to come back and clean that stuff up. But the punch really helps you get in there and get some nice round radiuses, easier than you could do from, let's say, drilling or cutting with an x-acto blade. And then I come and I cut out all the other ones. I cut through the other two layers to reveal all my shapes and get everything pretty close to what the final thing is going to be. I'm going to come in here with a little round rat tail file in the corners to clean things up and make things square, and doesn't take very much. It's just paper. Once we're done with the rat tail around file, we're gonna switch to a nail file. Actually, it's just nice and flat, easy to use, just about the right size. I can get it into those tiny little spaces. I don't have to make something custom. I'm gonna come back here with a bone folder just to smooth out that last layer. If it didn't fold out just right, you can smooth it out and the heat will help with that. And here what I'm doing is I am laying in with a fine Sharpie where the sheet metal would actually be bent, because I did not build that in. I don't want to take the time to do all that extra calculating and figuring out. So I'm gonna just draw that in, and that would be flipped up from the bottom piece. The last thing that's left to do here is to drill some holes, just like we would in a piece of wood or sheet metal. I'm just gonna do this on the drill press with a countersink bit, and that's gonna let us see what the part looks like with the holes in it, something that you would use for wall mounting. I got two in the middle, so if you had just the one stud to screw into, you could get plenty of strength. The other ones are maybe a little wider if you had a board or some sort of material to screw into that wasn't, say, a sheetrock that was a little more substantial. Just clean everything up here really quick on the belt sander. It doesn't take a lot. I'm not pressing very hard. We're just making everything nice and flat and smooth and square. It's an easy way to trim up the layers of the cardboard and get them nice and flat. We got a little bit of flash that came from drilling the countersinks, and I'm just trimming those up with an X-acto. And then the one that is too deep here, you're going to see me do that with a utility blade. I'm going to reach in there because it's a longer blade. It's going to allow me to scrape off that little bit of a rim. We'll clean it off, and we're done. I'm rather surprised by how strong this matboard mockup actually is. Here's the magic moment, of course, where you get to test out your mockup, see how things fit and hold, the little mistakes that you made, the things that you want to make better and modify for the next round of your design process. All right. Hope you enjoyed this video of making a matboard mockup to simulate a sheet metal bent folded parts. Keep leaving those comments below. I love the support.
Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. You can do that by clicking on the icon in the bottom right of the video or below the video. Give it a thumbs up and follow the channel there as well. You want to know about upcoming design content and projects that I'm working on? Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and my favorite Google+. Links below. Also, don't forget to check out all the design and making gear below.
Rock on!
Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.